I try to support all black stuff, man. All black stuff. Anybody here sell bootleg tapes? I've been trying to support them, but hey, if you're selling bootleg tapes out there, watch the tape before you sell it to me. You take them tapes on, all kind of shit be on them tapes, don't it? I mean, I'm trying to support the brother. I get a bootleg tape, get home, you know, and I got surround sounds. So I'm sitting there trying to watch, and it's a bunch of people arguing on the damn tape. There was so much arguing going on. Finally, I stood up and said, "Well, you niggas shut up." And I was the only one in the room. I ain't doing so much arguing. I just left out halfway through the movie. I left out. Went to Burbank to see it at the movie theater. When I came back, them niggas was still arguing. I'm like, yeah, duh. I try to support all these brothers, man, in the hood. If you're doing something positive, I try to support you. I was in the hood the other day, and there's a brother in the hood selling throwback jerseys. You know what throwback jerseys are, right? That's the retro jerseys of famous players that are not playing anymore, they're retired. But you ever have somebody make you a deal so good, you start to question the merchandise? The brother was selling throwback jerseys. So I went up to him, I said, "Hey, man, I want to support you. How much are the jerseys?" I said, "How much do they cost in the store first, you know, I mean, because I want to try to, you know, measure what I'm getting." He said, "Oh, man, they about $500 in the store, about $500. I said, "Okay, well, how much you selling them for?" "Oh, you can get one for $60. I said, "60? That's a hell of a markdown right there, you know what I'm saying? So I started asking him a few questions about the merchandise, and he started getting upset with me because I'm trying to inquire about the merchandise. So I said, "Hey, what size are they? What is that?" He said, "Yeah, that's a triple X. That's a triple X right there." So I said, "Well, check it out. If I wash it, it ain't gonna shrink, is it?" He like, "Nigga, you might lose an X or two, but it'll still be a large. Come on, bro. You gonna buy this or not? What's up, bro? What's up?" So I'm like, hold up, bro. I said, "Hold up, I just got a couple more questions. Let me see what time it is." So I reached down in the bag and I pulled out a Miami Dolphins jersey. Miami Dolphins jersey, a number 2. Miami Dolphins jersey. Now these are supposed to be jerseys of famous people. So I'm sitting there, I'm going, "Number 2, number 2. Number 2, number 2. Miami, number 2. Who was number 2? I'm thinking he's just gonna jump in at any time. He don't say a word. I'm like, "Number 2, number 2, number 2. Finally, I said, "Man, who was number 2? He like, "Nigga, I don't know. I wasn't born back then. You gonna buy this or not, bro? You gonna buy this or not?" You know, I'm gonna try to get myself together, so I wanted to take some karate. You know, so I said to myself, I said, "Yeah, you know, I need to try to get a brother's this money." Because, you know, I didn't want to go to the Asians, because if you notice in the hood now, brothers is like dojos all over the hood, everywhere. Check cashing joint, karate store, right next to it. Check cashing karate, check cashing karate, go all the way down the street. So I called myself, I said, "Well, let me just, you know, go down here and support the brothers or whatever." But you ever walk into some place and get that little voice and say, "Hey, you better go to the Asians, that's what you better do, you better go to the Asians." But I ignored the voice. I said, "No, I'm gonna try to support the brother." But there were certain things that told me I shouldn't do it. Like, you know how most karate instructors, when you walk into the dojo, they got pictures of themselves on the wall? You know, picture breaking boards, picture in a tournament, you know what I'm saying? A picture with a big ass trophy. This brother got pictures up that ain't got shit to do with karate, you know what I'm saying? Him at the club with 2 holes and his green cutlass chilling. Him and Shaq. Him and his 4 kids, you know what I'm saying? So that was the first clue that I should have left. I said, "Nah, I'm gonna try to work with the brother. I'm gonna try to work with the brother." And you know how most karate instructors let you fight according to your rank. You know, white belts fight white belts. Blue belts fight blue belts. This brother just let anybody fight anybody. He's smoking weed. All right, you two Negroes fight. Go ahead, fight. And then as soon as somebody get hurt, you know what I'm saying? He be like, hey, don't look at me. You just can't just run up on anybody just because I told you to run up on him like that. Bring your ass over here and smoke some of this weed, though. You'll forget about that pain. Come on over here. This will make you forget about that pain, bro. And then he get us involved in his personal life. You know what I mean? Come in late and just get us involved in his personal life. He come in on the phone. Now, I'm going to see my son. I wish you would try to keep me from seeing my son. I don't care how many brothers you got. You think I'm scared of your brothers? I tell you what, we about to handle this right now, all right? Yeah, we about to handle this. Hey, y'all get your stuff. Hey, get your stuff. Now get all your stuff, bro. I'm like, what's going on? We about to have a tournament tonight. That's what we about to have, a tournament on 43rd and Crenshaw, yeah. Whoever make it back, you get your next belt. That's how we gonna roll with this.